We're about to have the world premiere of Junkyard Juke. We are getting into set number two. The Funky Fighters have one Silver Llama. Who will get the second? We now are in to set two, match one. And right away, you can see Chapa, Gotaga, Magma, and RTA of Raven's Revenge. And then the Little Whip Warriors, Ninja, Taco, Taldak, and FaZe Kaz taking their shots off. Now, fun fact, the screens are there. You can't see, but you can shoot through them. So don't be afraid to take some shots. I mean, we know the trick shotters will.
Yeah, some people are already shooting. They figure that part out. It looks like Chappie hasn't quite yet. He's kind of looking. He's just blind shooting. Oh, there it is. Now he's firing through. He's noticed, hey, these are not ricocheting off of this curtain here. I can fire right on through. So you want to stop him. You want to force stop him. You want to also kind of memorize the map and the lanes.
And right away, you can see as soon as the blinds go down, people go. But the first points are starting to come through as Lachlan is able to get in. And Blood's team, the Llama Record Co., also able to get a 10-pointer and then a 5-pointer, following it directly behind. Oh no, it was another 10-pointer. So we already see some of the props having successful runs.
Look at him go. There it is. You saw a big old truck kind of sneak on by. And these objects are slipping right underneath. But who knows how long that'll last. Here's scissors. You got to park it. You got to stay still. Oh, can he blend in?
And one other thing you can note there, the props will clip through other objects that are there. So if you see something that isn't sitting perfectly naturally, like scissors was, right there, clipped into it, boom, got him, brilliantly done. Lachlan hits one of those bounce pads that are stuck in there. They will launch you up in the air. But great run coming out from X-Sandy and Tamoya, utilizing the air conditioners to find their way to the end. Benzor and Alex JJ desperately trying to get in. Alex JJ with another 10-point prop, and Hand of Blood gets picked up just before. That would have been a huge swing, but right now, Sunshine Soldiers in first place with 35 points.
They are finding their rhythm here. Sunshine Soldiers taking the lead right now. This is a hard game mode to break free in because you got to think about it. These guards are not playing around. They are shooters, right, at heart. And at the end of the day, if something looks off, something looks odd, like this white vent right here, you're just gonna get popped. So you gotta be careful here. And there it is, nice job of, you know, kind of hitting the brakes here. And oh, he hits one of those trap doors. Let's talk about that sundown.
So you can actually see it. There is the little tiny springs. They launch you upward. There's a couple that can be chained into each other. But if you are one of those bigger objects and you get sent up, you are just quite literally sometimes flying garbage.
Yeah. But, you know, it would be too easy if we didn't lay traps around, right? So, you know, gotta kind of spice it up for the people that are turned into props too.
So you can also, actually, the people who can turn into props, there's one pathway where you can chain two of them together. So if you can get there, you almost land directly in front of it. So as long as you time it correctly, you can like use them slightly to your advantage, but most of the time, they're a little bit more annoying. And boom,
that's
you can
huge.
See that rusted truck going in. And now the Funky Fighters pulling out another lead, 60 points so far.
And this is something important to note, guys. You have to get it into the incinerator, fully processed before the timer counts down, or else your point will not be processed.
Which is a big thing on the min-maxing. What we mean by that is maximizing your efficiency. So if you were to get the most points possible, you run only 10 points the entire time, not only because they're worth more, but they take less time to sort because they're the first one that goes through. The two-point props are able to run, I don't want to say relatively easier, but much easier compared to a dumpster and a card, particularly because you have cover. With that being said, take about an extra 3 to 4 seconds to sort, so it makes it that much less efficient, plus being only 20% of the point value.
That's right. So Clytax there has chosen a big object. Achin and Zond over here, smaller objects. They're kind of blending right into all of the dumpster trash, clearly harder to track down and kind of, I guess, how do I say this? Sort out, right?
Yeah.
Amongst all the clutter here.
Exactly. You want things that don't stick out, or you want some. You want to find a path for an object that you can take all the time. So you notice how there's a section where there's like 4 or 5 rusted cars. Grab a rusted car and go park yourself with those. Because yes, the guy knows. Oh, there's a bunch of rusted cars there. Screen goes back up. Oh, there's still a bunch of rusted cars there. I'm good. Next thing you know, the problem walks his way up. You can also, as you're running, walk rotation. So if you hit your crouch button, whatever you have that bound to, whether you're playing on controller, iPad, PC, all of them end up completely stopping. So it will set you totally naturally, just like what you would see.
And this is also those moments, right, when you're in the guard. Oh, someone spotted there, popped him. Tamoya, nice job seeing something out of the ordinary. But notice, He gets an elimination on the object. You don't earn points for that. So it's just your job to stop everyone from getting any kind of points. So don't break away with the lead. When you're in the guard tower, you can't allow the group to score, and you're not scoring.
Which can end up being very interesting if the team in the lead, which generally happens because you have three chances to score, is shooting last round. Right? Because then it's all about how good are your pressure. And one other thing you can see, starting to fire through the screens, very well done for them, picking up an elim there. But right now, Cuddle Crew already resting the lead away. All three of them sitting there at 60, but they're 5-point processes, and it goes through as two more dumpsters throw themselves into the fray.
Yeah, and that's because the Funky Fighters cannot earn points here in the guard round. The Sunshine Soldiers using this opportunity once again to just break away even closer to taking lead. And the Chicken Champions can't earn anything either.
I love that from Clytex right away. Hides himself behind the box, and you see his hands. He's like, please, please make sure it's not there. And then boom, gets the point, gets a nice little celly going in. And you can see all of them getting sorted there. Another way, I'm all about the min-maxing. Point your camera towards the end. You go just a little bit faster.
Sundown pulling out the strats here. The question is, can our competitors figure it out fast enough with their limited amount of games here? But 20 seconds on the clock. Can he get this in time? Remember, you gotta grab the dumpster, drop the dumpster, and get it processed. That was perfect.
That was so good by Stuart000 because he dodged the little springboard there. You saw him look at it and be like, oh, no, I'm good. And that was the last run. None of these props are going to be able to get and get sorted. Lachlan gets picked out at the end. You can see 3, 2, 1, but not going to be enough. You need to get all the way through and sorted on the point as the rest of the denial comes through. And we're gonna rotate the guards up again.
Yes, so we will have some new guards take their place. This is honestly Chicken Champions' opportunity to start scoring some points and hopefully close up the gap here. The Sunshine Soldiers are now at the bottom layer of the guard tower, and the Fish Fam are at the top. So it is time to kind of mix it up.
My eyes are on the Funky Fighters right now. They are
doing great.
They're very close, and on top of that, they're the team with the Silver Llama.
Yep.
As we've talked about, they are so incredibly close, doing everything they can to push towards the top. And you can see they got a lot of elims too in the round where they were playing defense. So not a ton of scoring going past them, only 35 points off the pace. But what I'm shocked about right now is there is nobody running 2-point props at all, zero.
Tamori is a genius. He was already spotted out for the statue. He kind of hit over to the side and said, you know what, I kind of got to wait here. I can't park this statue on the open. He's going to be hunting for me. And that's exactly what he does. Kind of sits it over on the side there. And that's how he earns himself another point. So they're actually playing very, very smart here. And that's why they've been doing so good at these competitions.
I think the guards need to be slightly more aggressive. It's unlimited ammunition. You can't run out.
Oh.
If you think something is suspicious, or if you just want to take a shot at it, shoot your shot.
Yeah.
What's the worst case that happens? You miss? There's no accuracy stats going on there. If something looks suspicious, don't let it through. You're the guards, and you want to deny as much as possible. And again, every match is for $55,000 for the winning team. You want that, and that will lead into the Llamas as well. You don't want to end up in that 4th to 8th spot. You want to push past your competitors as we see a whole mess of air conditioners going in there. The water heater's in. It was fantastic for Raven's Revenge, and Llama Record Co. are also climbing their way up the leaderboard, 110 points so far.
Great job for the Llama Record Company. Alex, JJ, Carnifex, Venos, and Hand of Blood. This team is doing great right here as they seemingly inch their way to the top somehow, overtaking the Cuddle Crew. Which, by the way, Lackland's team has been showing up here. It's good to see them, you know, catch a little bit of domination here in this Junkyard Juke.
Well, like we said, the creative finals is all about celebrating the different types of creative skills. There's different ways to express that. We have the World Run where it's there. We saw Sky Station Showdown, which shows off building in team tactics. And right now, Prop Hunt is all about min-maxing efficiency, working together, and hitting your shots.
Yeah, absolutely, because when you're in that guard tower, you don't have opportunity to miss. You let them score, they're going to break free and break away with the lead. Just a look at Svenos here, who's that bullseye just kind of blending right in.
The archery target, there's a lot of them out there, but you need to be careful because they're slightly harder and come on.
Uh-oh.
Really?
He's floating up there.
You can see kind of like the look on his face. He's like, there's no way this works. And one other thing to talk about is orientation of your props. So you notice he actually swapped his camera and pointed in the other direction.
Oh.
Unfortunately, was clipping into the trash bag there. But if you're running forward, your prop faces backwards. So you need to run and then turn settle yourself. That's the best way, or you orient yourself around the stuff that's near you, because if you're facing in a totally random direction, that'll earn a bullet in most circumstances.
I love how aggressive they were at the final moments. The clock was
You gotta
ticking.
Go!
Yeah, the clock was ticking. They're like, you know what, we gotta get in here. But that was round three of four for this first game right here. And, you know, it's kind of going either which way. So if you've already had your shot at the guard tower, you're safe. You're good. You can keep getting points. But this is your last opportunity. If you're in a guard tower, that's all the points you got. That's it. They have to hold strong.
So this is where it really comes into mind. Who is running? Who is in the tower? And what does the scoreboard look like? So right now we can see right away Llama Wrecker Co. is up there. And I believe it's with, I didn't see who that other team was. When we pan back over, we'll call that out. But Llama Wrecker Co. is in first right now. And I think Cuddle Crew is with them as well. So it's typical that the top two would be up there. And it is. The top two teams are in the guard tower. So right now, everyone needs to unseat them. Otherwise, they will take this first match of set two.
I'll be honest with you, it's a pretty big lead. That's a substantial lead. Whoever is left in the game, the Sunshine Soldiers, the Funky Fighters, the Chicken Champions, you gotta bring these big items through and do it successfully with the limited time left in this round right here, because if not, it's gonna be hard to catch up to that 150.
We're starting to see a little bit more consistency right there. And look at Spenna shooting. He's just shooting everything. He's not worried in terms of going through there. Does hit one Elim, fires the shots off, going through, trying to look at just anything that he thinks doesn't look normal. Anything that maybe not have been there before.
It's like one of my favorite things, watching him just shoot the boxes like, what's that? Was that there? Was that there? Was that there? Was that there? He's just taking his shots. That's exactly what you got to do here if you want to hold this lead here. And that's why they're dominating. You can see the no hesitation really coming out of them. And that's why they have the lead right now. And it's great. It's great that they're hitting his shots. It's great that Spenos is holding it down.
But the Funky Fighters, we talked about it, eyes on them, already up to 120. One more 10-point prop will put them past. And unfortunately for Ninja there, does get hit on the springboard, but gets in anyway. So just a little bit of time loss. And great shot from Lachlan. My lord, I barely even saw that.
Four Turtle from Australia hit a springboard and Lachlan shut that down. His fellow Australian brother right there, very nicely done. You don't want to hit those springboards, man.
And now you can see 125 from the Funky Fighters. They're doing everything they can to overtake. They want this match victory. They want to keep the momentum rolling, but the Cuddle Group is doing a great job of picking up targets and running their timeout, getting some both right as they get out of spawn and before they're about to score, which the waste of time is even that much more efficient, but unfortunately not finding anything there.
Yeah, Lachlan is really not timing his kind of rotations and reloads properly. Notice he's not also utilizing the shooting through the curtain factor there. He's kind of holding himself back. That's why you saw him with a couple Elims right there, but gotta put that pressure down, lock down these lanes so that they don't just get like free rotations through, right?
And again, we talked about it a little bit. I'm very surprised nobody is just consistently running 2-point props. You can get them in close to every run if you pick the right path and you take the covered angles. It's very difficult to stop them, particularly with the smaller hitbox, but so far we've only seen two scored.
Yep, and I like that. Cuddle Crew right there, 130 points. This is their time. Cuddle Crew still doing really good defense right here. Oh no, but you know, Cassius Curse, I feel so bad. Chicken Champion comes up out of nowhere, takes that one right away.
Able to get him there, and now the Funky Fighters, 5 points out. Anything going in will be enough, and the time ticks over. They didn't get it in there. Oh! Did they get it in there? They might have got the 5 point right at the end, but no, wasn't enough. Llama Wrecker Co. on the defense says, lock it up. We good. Brilliantly done from them. And that's what I'm talking about. When you're sitting there on defense, you know exactly how long you need to keep them out, exactly what you need to do in order to take the victory. And no surprise there, the guys who are all about that apocalypse game mode during the creative trials, able to take home the very first match ever on Junkyard Juke.
That was well played. A valiant effort for everyone that participated in that run right there. And it was a close one. 150 points to the contender having 145. Just 1 point. One small radiator.
And this is what I'm talking about, where if you had one person who is running just 2-point props there and got their successful runs at the end, they would have it. That's three successful runs. That takes about a minute, and you could have collected it.
So go ahead.
Nobody opted to.
Maybe some of these guys need a little help here. Let's redo this. What would you suggest here, Sundown?
I don't want to say suggest, but I had an opportunity to play a decent amount of it. I'm a big fan of kind of adjusting based off of the scoreline. So if you're seeing you're able to consistently keep running two-point props, get the guaranteed points. If somebody's playing really good defense and you're not getting 10-point props in, you need to pivot away from that strategy. Because getting any points at all is better than none, and particularly if you waste a run on a dumpster where the entire time you're going and then you're stopping, and then you're going and then you're stopping. Eventually, even if you get all the way to the end, sometimes it's not enough, right? And then you've wasted that 35, 45 seconds, three rotations to get just there, whereas you could have grabbed the burger, grabbed the bucket, and ran the entire time, weaved around, trying to like catch a good area, as we saw with the statue, able to hide around a corner. So would love to see in the next match a little bit more, I don't want to say like determination going into it, but be a little bit more deliberate.
That's right, but let's go in and hear from some of the deliberate actions over with Zeke, down with our winners.
What's up, guys? I'm hanging out with the Llama Record Company. They took away the prop hunt 5-point lead. You guys locked it up at the very end. Annabelle, I'm going to start with you. And one person I want to call out specifically is this man right here, Svenos. Very tall, tallest man on the planet. It feels like this guy is a very good pick for your team. And I want to know why him, and then also why you picked these other two.
Yeah, I mean, I picked all those guys because this game mode is all about skill. There are no random things in it. You need good aim, you need decision-making for sure. And Svenos, I mean, he's like a Spano. He really likes Spano. That's kind of the best city in the world. And that's why I picked him first, for example.
Okay, now Svenos, I'm going to put you on blast for a second because we've known each other quite a while. You know, I'd like to believe that your creativity is what allowed you to win. Let's think back to the time where you wore an entire green outfit and you danced and had a galaxy over yourself. Do you feel like that galaxy and that kind of creativity helped you get this dub?
I don't know what you're talking about, mate.
I think people at home that watched, you guys probably know exactly what I'm talking about. Let's go over this way now. What did you think about that game? Was it what you expected? Was it different? Did it catch off guard? Were you ready to just jump into it?
It's enjoyable. Once you get the hang of it, it gets a lot easier. You just got to work out who's good at aiming, which team's on the tower. And after that, you're good.
All right, final question. Do you think you have what it takes? Is the Llama Record Company going to be the team? You think someone else is standing in your way, or is it all you guys?
I think it's going to be all us, yes.
There you go. Man, a few words, that's all they need. Gentlemen, thank you so much. Best of luck going forward. Back to you guys on the desk.
Thank you so much, Zeke. Another brilliant performance there coming out of the Llama Record Company. We talked about their versatility. We talked about how quickly they pick up competitive matches. But this is what happened in the first set, right? They were there. They were confident. They're like, yeah, once you get it, it's easy. And then all the other teams immediately caught up. So it'd be very interesting to see if that same story from set one is what's happening in set two.
Yep, that's right. Alex up there said it best. You know, he had the confidence. He felt good in those final moments. Hey, you know, once you figure out who's aiming, maybe just avoid him.
Yeah, I mean, if somebody is hitting all their shots, you need to take a different route. You can't go and continuously challenge them because, again, we talked about that. If you waste all the time to run through and the guy hits a lucky, or I don't want to say lucky blind fire, but a consistent blind fire through there, don't keep running that way. But like we said, this is the first time seeing the Junkyard Juke mode, and we talked about the prop hunt mode earlier, but you can play it live right now in-game. There's an LTM that's available only for this weekend. Let's check it out. Like we said, you can check that out live in client. It's an LTM that is available only for this weekend. And Monster, have you had a chance to play Prop Hunt?
Well, all week long now, I finally really got to experience the Prop Hunt. And before this, I kind of heard you guys talk about it. I was like, is that something I want to try out? But no, it honestly was very fun.
There's so many just fun moments, but the ability to then push it to a competitive level. These guys are doing great, but we're now going to get into match two of set two. The second time you will have seen Junkyard Juke, and let's see who is able to push on. The match is about to start. Here we go. The creative finals at the Fortnite World Cup. Set two, match two of Junkyard Juke.
That's right. So in the tower, We have Ninja's team, the Little, Whip, Warriors, Taco, Gaz, Taldoc. We're jumping straight into their POV. So notice Ninja firing right through those blinds. He saw something moving back there. He's trying to pinpoint. What was it? He does, of course, track him down to Sport Turtle. Ooh, just a little pixel. You know, you stand out, you're going to get popped here.
He needs to make sure he's still watching his left-hand side, though, because there is a whole run on that corner right now where people would be able to come out, and now all of a sudden you see Alex JJ, Tyler, Ryan Fanta, MSYB all heading that direction. Nobody is checking that corner. He's checking it every now and then, but he's primarily aiming on the right, and right as I say that now looks back on over as the rush comes through, but MSYB and Rubius are able to get in. Brilliantly done from them, getting the first points on the board as the Funky Fighters again are able to pull out to a decent lead.
What do you think? Would you rather be up in the guard tower first and kind of get that out the way? Or would you prefer to kind of jump in as a prop and get your points first?
So for me, it depends if I can get a lead. If I have a lead, obviously I want to be a guard tower at the end because I'm very confident in my ability to just spam shots in the right direction because I know like I can find the sight line and all that. With that being said, if you can get in the guard tower early and you do incredibly well, it gives you the bonus. You know how many points you need to get. You know how consistent and fast you can run. And right now we're seeing a lot more 5-point props than last round. People consistently trying to get those in, recognizing, hey, they're a little bit quicker. People are finding their angles now. But as I say that, Achi for the Sunshine Soldiers gets in that truck. 10 points going over to them, and 15 actually, as a 5-pointer got sorted right at the same time.
That was perfect. Yeah, and the Sunshine Soldiers had a great last run. Achin and his crew really pulled it together. They were at the top for a while there, but in those final moments, we saw the Chicken Champions take away and kind of break away. And now look, no surprise, Chicken Champs, they're feeling it. They found their rhythm towards the end of the last one. If they carry that over, this is going to be a close one.
Yeah, and you can see Carnifex hits the jump pad twice over there, doing everything he can to not get hit, and he does get the teddy bear in.
Ooh.
10 points going through, and Clytex gets picked right at the edge.
Right through the current. Taco is like, you know what? I'm going to check the close area. Look at how Chappie's doing it as well. He's actually eliminated 9 props so far, so he is really firing away here, trying to see if anyone's trying to make a mad dash while the curtains are up, and Sandy gets caught right there.
Good shot right away. 20 seconds left, so players need to start running if they're going. Good shots coming out from Trappy to get it there and get the reload off. Saw the truck over on the side, is able to pick that one up, and now is looking for the smaller props towards the side. Knew there was movement, just wants to fire it up. Only 10 seconds left. They should be able to get the defense, but there goes a bucket. Look at it.
Oh,
the cactus
are hard to hit.
There goes, able to pick it up just at the last second. Good attempt from Pewtwo, and you can see the points already coming across. Players so far sticking to their game plan. 5 and 10 point props all the way.
That is the way to go. Inch your way up and over to that victory there. But that was just the first round of 4 here. Round 2 is going to begin. What's going to happen now is, again, the guard tower is going to mix up. We're going to see new players in the guard tower and then the other players that were previously in the guard tower back on the prop hunt floor.
Yes, you get 1 round in the guard tower, 3 rounds running as the props, and you can see right away now you have the Funky Fighters up top, and the shots go out as soon as the blinds go down, not letting anything happen as the props march their way out of spawn.
This is fun right here. I love watching these trucks waddle about, really trying to find their way, and they see the light go to change, plant themselves down, and they're back out to the field here.
Yep, and desperately trying to avoid. Oh, there's no way. You're stacked on top of each other. Come on, you gotta shoot one of the two. Shots are going towards it, but right now, Zan trying to get that cuddly cute teddy bear into the incinerator. Not a sentence I ever thought I would say there, as the archer is now doing everything he can. Hits the bounce target twice and is able to convert as Magma gets another good run and sneaks in under the shots of Dracius.
That's right. This is just getting closer and closer. We have a 3-way tie now. The Fish Fam, Llama Wrecker Company, the Cuddle Crew, all at the top here, and it's still a very close game so far. Danyan right here from the Sunshine Soldiers, peeking around, using that camera angle, trying to see when it's time, wants to waste no time here. Bat, it goes down, and off to the races she goes. But will it change? Yep. Actually, stops early, too. Says, you know what, I'm going to play it safe. I'm going to stop before the curtain comes up.
and she has to be having a blast right now. She says one of her favorite things about creative mode is kind of the wacky and wainy and situations you get into, particularly like prop hunt. So this must be a game mode that she's doing incredibly well and enjoying herself in. As you can see there, her team is able to get a couple of props in there. Gotaga and Clytex try to make the final little sprint. Hand of Blood gets another 10 points over, as does Taco with a 5-point statue there. Scissors is hanging around on the side there. Will go through. No, I did not mean to call you trash. You just are a dumpster now, quite literally.
Quite literally, but oh, the rage. I read the lips. He said, I was so mad. He got taken out right there. And I like this. Let's see how he decides. He's going for those 10 points, though. Notice he went straight to the right for the big objects. That's the risk.
That's what it is about. That's what happens. You need to be careful not only of the fact you're bigger, easier to see while you're moving, but you need to find a blank space in order to set down. Can't be clipping into anything else with 45 seconds remaining in round two. And you can see Svetoz, a minute before, the guard looked at him. He's like, I don't... Nah, I'm out. Right there. And right now, relatively top heavy. 70-70, and as I said, Fishrip does get their 80th point, but Lachlan hanging out on top of the rubble, 28 seconds left, does find an angle.
Oh, that you know, no he actually really didn't watching. Park either. He just jumped on top of it. You know, I haven't been to this section here where all the vehicles
so
are.
So this is the section I'm talking about where you can grab a burger in a bucket, go out, and not expose yourself except for during one period. And as long as you either full run the time through or you opt to sit still during that time, then you're good. You will score literally every single run. It's just you have to be a 2-point prop and you have to go to that exit.
Oh, Danyan right there, unfortunately, couldn't push through in those final moments there. And that was round two of four, as we are looking to get into round three next. So they can earn some more points. And every single set matters, right? Every game matters, because there's a lot of prize on the line.
Yes, every single match is scored. The top four will receive a gradient of money going from $55,000 down to $20,000, and then you have the fourth through 10th all receiving 10. That prize is then decided who will receive the Silver Llama. The Funky Fighters currently have one, but who will be able to press with them?
Clytax, that vehicle is way too big, buddy. You can't just be trying to squeeze it behind that and not think someone's gonna see the tail end of it. Here we have Bensor and Drakias close by one another. Bensor gets popped through the blinds there. And wait, so he's gonna take a couple shots. He said, does his truck belong here? He did miss though. Lucky for him, the bad aim and that moment right there is gonna allow him to sneak that big 10 point. No! He gets taken out right there. That's no points for him. 10 is huge in his mode too. It's very difficult to get a vehicle all the way through.
I mean, it's swingy, right? If you think about it, the last round was one with 150 points, right? So if you get a singular 10-point profit, that's not an insignificant percentage there. Like, that's going to be able to help your team, but you also need to set your feet there, as Kororo didn't hit the crouch button. It was like, I see you wiggling a little bit there. Yoink.
And there's Ninja, Ryan, Pronta, Chappie, many others still in the running here. Peeking around, you see Tyler shooting straight through the curtain. It almost looks like he's beelining his shots down the aisle there, trying to see if he can get anyone trying to exit out. Zan sees one pop up in the air, and I think he might have clipped that person out.
Nobody is watching that side.
Oh,
Fishfam needs to communicate better right now. Nobody was covering that other side, and we saw two teams able to get a decent run out. But right now, Llama Record Company still holding the lead, sitting at 100 points. But don't forget, Fishfam are up on top right now. Are the guards, which means they're not scoring points.
He's so fast. Ryan Bronze is so fast here with this prop. Even moving it, he doesn't care. He's going all the way for it. He's got to watch for traps. See the fear? He's like, you know what? I'm not even going to risk it. I'm going to wait here and get the secure point.
So one important thing to notice, too, is Ryan is taking paths consistently that take him to the corner of the guard tower, because the corner provides you with a little bit of natural cover, and it breaks that sight line up. If you're only staring out in one direction, it's super easy to be like, no, that car was not there. I know it wasn't. If you're flipping back and forth across that corner piece, it just breaks up your field of view a little bit more, and it's that much harder to try and figure out what's actually gonna hit.
That's right, and oh boy, is MSYB gonna be able to sneak this huge truck in? Oh, he actually hit something there. He's gonna sneak it right underneath. Lucky for him, the shot did not come back in time, but just that big archery target was almost enough to kind of block him right there. Venos gets another large object in as well. That's another 10-pointer for the Llama Record. It was fully processed here, so now he's at 130. Can the Cuddle Crew hold the lead here, though? Can they secure it? All the Llama Record Company needs to not score right now, and they'll continue to kind of stay in the lead.
And you can see Scissors is hitting a ton of shots. They're trying to get the Retribution as the guard, and now we're heading in to our final round of match number two. So we'll see who the guards are, see what the stakes are, and who will be able to take that number one spot. Again, first place, $55,000, and that much closer to Silver Llama number two. And again, we have the Cuddle Crew and Llama Record Co. up on defense. Let's check out that scoreboard. And Cuddle Crew, Llama Record Co., first and second. Who will be able to overtake them? And they are so close to 5 points separating. It's a battle for first and second now.
Yes, Lackland and the rest of his team are trying their hardest. They have to stop people from scoring. The Chicken Champions get up. They can just easily snag this away. But for now, they know the Llama Record Company cannot. They can't take them over.
Ooh, I thought he was going to shoot that car. He knew it wasn't there.
Nice.
Finds the box right around the corner and then gets another one right after. Blind fire through the shade as El Rubius is looking to post up there. Spanish YouTuber trying to find a way in, trying to lead his team, and they've overtaken the Llama Record Co. with plenty of time and are tied with the Cuddle team. Any singular point now will put the Chicken Champions as our match two winner. They need one prop.
That's right, they're so close here. Magma trying to hop on over. Who's it gonna be for the Chicken Champions? Who's gonna be?
Do you think they get a 2-point prop? They have the scoreboard in front of them. They know they need only that. Do you think they run one in, or do you think they stay with what they're doing right now?
Honestly, I think they're just gonna stay with what they're doing. It's working. Why break the formula here? They have over a minute to do so. And just like that, they are gonna
stay
in here.
And that will be it. Yes, brilliantly done. They're overtaking them. And now the question is, can the Little Whip Warriors get enough in to catch them? It's a 25-point spread, but you can get that. You have four runners.
Yes.
You can get that in a single run if you're well coordinated enough. Will they be able to catch up, or can the Chicken Champions edge it out and be our match two victors?
That's right, because the Cuddle Crew is now bumped out. The Chicken Champions are holding it. Little Whip Warriors have scored, though. 1 minute left here. Uh-oh. Raven's Revenge coming up as well, as is the Fish Fam. This is actually getting closer than we would have thought. They're close to pushing out the Cuddle Crew and the Llamas.
Yep, and Little Whip Ninja also getting the 5 points there. Will be able to overtake. Don't forget, you don't want to end up fourth to eighth. It's all about at least breaking in the top four to get a little bit of the differentiation there in the prizing. But the Chicken Champions are pulling ahead. They're keeping that 25-point difference so far between the Little Whip Warriors. Little Whip needs to find a coordinated run with 10-point props in these last 30 seconds, or they're not going to get it. Meanwhile, Bensor running that statue in, trying to lock up everything he can for the lead. And he's being extremely patient with it, taking a corner run, finding everything he needs to do. Little Whip does get a 5 and a 10, and they're still now only 20 points behind, but Bensor is going to be able to lock that one up from there. 5 points, 25, 15 seconds left. The Chicken Champions are sitting pretty.
Yes, that's right. If the Little Whip Warriors don't score big right now with all big props, it's going to be all over in 3 seconds, and it's not going to be enough here because the Chicken Champions, they actually pushed the lead even further.
Did you see what happened at the last second?
They did score.
No, no, no. Raven's Revenge grabbed a 2-point prop, hard ran all the way through, got it in, right? And then that pushed them from fourth into third. When we talk about every little interaction mattering, that was it. But the Chicken Champions, one might be able to say that was excellent. They were able to tender defend that title for the match two victory and putting them in a good spot to contend for the set two Llama.
You can see the excitement there on their faces as they just realize, hey man, we got this. We're in the running here. The Junkyard Juke could be ours.
And you can see they're still talking gameplay right now. Like, they want to know, what can we do more? That play you did right there was awesome, but they want the next one because there's 3 matches for each one of the sets, and a win there would put them in a fantastic spot to get the second Silver Llama. You need that in order to be in contention, and if they're able to split it up away and deny it from the Funky Fighters, it feels wide open.
Yes, it's not over yet. That's just another team who takes the victory here, making it that much closer of a running so far. and we saw the Raven's Revenge kind of sneak up too. You need as many points as possible. The bigger the placement, the better the prize as well for the round, so you can't just give up either. You got to push it all the way to the final moment.
And hey, hats off to whoever's call that was on Raven's Revenge. That was a brilliant decision, showing exactly why you're able to qualify for the Fortnite World Cup Creative Finals, why you're playing on that stage. Those are the big plays, but again, brilliantly done from the Chicken Champions. Consistent runs, stuck to their statues, stuck to their routes, and took the corners. And now we're actually going to have a chance to talk to our Chicken Champions, the Match 2 Champions. Zeke has them up there on the top floor. Zeke, what do you got for us?
What's going on, guys? I'm hanging out with the Chicken Champions, guys. That game was insane. Feathers were flying, and you guys clutched it up. Did you figure out the strategy? Because you guys were well and ahead of everybody else.
Yeah, we practiced yesterday, and everything is thanks to this guy. This guy always goes for the 10 points, always, and he always gets it. So thanks to you, man.
All right, then I'm coming to you, Mr. Carey. What was the strategy? How did you get the 10 points in there? Was it the same every time? Did you switch things up?
Yeah, I go for the 10 points each time and do the same strategy, and it seems to work. So,
so in this intense game of red light, green light, were you like stopping early, or were you just like going as far as you could go and then waiting for someone to spot you and stopping, or what was your plan?
No, I'm taking it very patiently.
Yeah. All right, now over to you guys. What do you guys think of this game mode? Has it been everything you thought it's been?
Yeah, it's great. We had a game plan. We definitely did what we came to do, and that's what we expected. So,
very well executed. You did not lay an egg. All right, final question for you. I want to give you the chance to tell the world, you know, all the fans something. What do you want to tell them?
Thanks for the support from Spain for the other world. And my team is... it's good in this mode, and will we win the next match?
There you go. The excitement is real. Gentlemen, congratulations. Best of luck going forward. We're sending it back your way.
Brilliantly done there from the Chicken Champions. Thank you so much, Zeke. They're excited to be there. They stuck to the gameplay. And shout out to Bensor. The one thing he was looking forward to on this trip, he wanted to play in front of a big crowd. He got that moment, running through, securing that for the Chicken Champions. An immediate El Rubius turned to him and was like, it's all him, man. He put the team on his back or put the team in his dumpster. I don't know, that normally that wouldn't be a good thing, but in this circumstance, hey, it worked out for him.
Yeah, another prop to Kyoto as well. The only or one of two controller players here, you know, in the creative finals. So very nice of him to kind of represent for those guys as well. And again, just showing that he's got the moves out there.
He had the moves, was able to find the right angles. And now we've seen some developments from match one to match two. Yep. What was the big thing that stuck out from you that was different?
And that last one, honestly, finally seeing someone pick up those two-point props, right? Using those are points right there. But with that, we'll jump over to Bala. We'll take a fun look at some of the things that developed in our last few moments.
Thank you so much, guys. Yes, the Junkyard Juke is developing nicely. Everybody's starting to figure out what all the different tools and props they have available to them. So with that, we're going to hop into some of the tips and tricks that I've seen from the Junkyard Juke so far. We can roll the clip right now as all these players. The first thing I want to point out is there are these springboards. Unfortunately, Dan Yen gets picked out of the sky there. Not too happy about that. But moving on to Tamoya using the statue. This is one of the interesting scores I saw with the statue, those higher point objects being useful. Scissors here with the springboard, the recovery, and just barely doesn't get into the incinerator at the last second. And then here we have Tamoya. No, sorry. We have, again, just an awesome run towards there, looking like a scene out of everybody, you know, crossing the street at the same time. Here's Tracius hitting some amazing shots through the black. And then he just continues shooting, just hoping that he can get a shot. This is the other team, the Cuddle Crew, doing the same thing, but then also synchronizing, making sure they have coverage on all angles. Finally, Tamoya made some amazing calls. We'll listen to them in a second, but this is what he did, always timing it perfectly so that he can get in and make sure that his teammates also go at the same time and make it into that incinerator. So we're gonna head and listen to what those communications were like from Tamoya and team. In this one, they made sure the count was perfect.
One, two, three, four, ten, I got ten, I got ten. We are nice. Ten. We are both.
One, two,
tap.
Three, four, five,
tap.
How they kill me.
If they don't kill me, I score ten.
Don't
one,
fire.
One, two, Okay, I got 5, I got 5.
I got 10. No! You kicked me! Oh. We are front team.
Yeah.
I scored 0 in the second round, that's the problem.
I scored 0 in the first one, so... Like, we are all close points.
There you go, the Funky Fighters. You know they won the first Silver Llama. We're gonna see if they can win the next one. We've got one more match here on Junkyard Juke to go, and we'll see who will come out on top with the Silver Llama from this. Guys, back to you.
Thank you so much, Bala, for that great breakdown. Listening to the comms, that's one thing I hadn't considered. I always just kind of like, yeah, it's going to come up now. But these guys all on comms talking, have one guy counted out. That guy's just like a metronome. Make sure he has it on the dot every single time. Brilliantly done from them. But will they be able to take back that top spot? We've seen them do it. If they can grab that Silver Llama, they'll be in such a good spot. But right now, they aren't seeing the same success they saw before.
Yeah, you want to get the Silver Llama, but to get there, you got to make a new strategy. I think that right there, there was a lot of information in that bit right there. You kind of noticed the team synergy, and he said something very important in his interview there. Talked about being patient. You really have to be patient. You can't let the frustration get to you. You saw Scissors very expressive on the cam. Just, it's hard to get the pointer, and that's what I talked about before this whole thing started. I said, trust me, this is a lot harder than you guys think. You might just, you know, oh yeah, I'll turn it to something and run it through. Nah, man, you're gonna get shut down.
But I mean, it's just like, if you think about it, it's the mental aspect that really comes with it. If you're able to frustrate somebody else, then they're that much more off their game. And these guys are all great at that, coming through from some of the Death Run qualifiers. It makes it that much harder. But thank you guys so much for joining us here. And again, don't forget, there is a fantastic, awesome event-specific merch starting here, right now, today on the 26th. You can also get it on RetailRow.com. Make sure you celebrate the event. Remember it, grab some from your friends, your brothers, your family, people who couldn't be here, and celebrate the first ever Fortnite World Cup.
Yeah, you saw some of your favorite pros and competitors here rocking that new swag. Definitely loving it. All types of collaborations going on here. I love it when Fortnite releases new gear, you know? It kind of allows me to always spice it up.
I'm always a fan of anything Fortnite swag. That's pretty much like 98% of my wardrobe. At this point, I mean, love the logos, love the bright colors, but enough from us. Match 3, set number 2, the final one on the original version of Junkyard Juke before we see the remix later on. Are you guys ready?
That's right.
And let's begin. The first round is underway. Match number 3, set number 2. Who will be able to incinerate the props the most? Who will push out to the lead? And can anybody upset the Funky Fighters who took that first llama? You need to make sure they don't get this one here. And basically, everyone's first place.
Yep, and you can see there, Taldak did land a shot straight through the curtain. Very nicely done. Another kind of lane, right? You want to look at your lane, see which lane is available to you that's easy to maneuver the objects you want to bring through. Clytex, for example, here is using a bear. There are no bears in this section, but he says, you know what? It's all good. I can sneak this around.
So the big thing with the bear, though, that you don't really consider is the coloring of the background. You're in the junkyard. You're a little bit in one of those desert biome situations. There's a lot of kind of muddle browns and oranges around there. It makes it that much harder to stick out. However, if you if you're grabbing the snowman, you're just really flexing on everyone. It's like, yeah, I'm a snowman. I'm a snowman in the desert, and I'm going to score on you.
That's pretty hilarious because, you know, we haven't seen anyone pull out the weird objects in the back end for good reason. There are a couple other fun ones back there. If we get a pan around later, you'll probably notice a big old snowman or something like that. But with all this money on the line, there's no way anyone has time to play around like that.
You can't play around because every single one of those runs matters. And right now, we see Sunshine Soldiers swapping over. They've already put in 2 2-point props, so need to be slightly more efficient on those runs. But good job getting on the board and consistently. And as we say that, 5-pointer goes in. Boom, they're ahead of the Funky Fresh, who have had a singular 10-point run. So trying to get every possible point. It's all about min-maxing efficiency.
Honestly, the Little Wimp Warriors are doing a great job at defending here. They all have a ton of eliminations. Taldak at 6, Taco at 5, Kaz and Ninja both tied at 7. That is pretty good. They're shutting down all of their lanes. These guys are not here to play. Remember, as you're a guard, you don't accumulate any points. So it's good. They're knocking this out the way, and they're doing a great job defending.
keeping them out, making sure you find the right lane angles, and also sometimes just putting shots out in the right spot. You just need to be able to consistently deny as much as possible. And Tal'Dorf, that was sick!
I was like, are you behind that? Yes, what's that? Didn't see that there before. Didn't see that either. Tal'Dorf doing a good job so far, spotting things through the curtain. Let's see if he can find another here with a random shot. Oh, something landed. That's why you don't want to hit those spring traps there.
They make it so difficult when you're a larger object coming back down because it's just so much motion on the screen. When everything else is still, if you see that thing falling through, like, it's an easy shot, particularly for all of these players up there. I mean, Gotaga and crew, everyone on Raven's Revenge, him, Magma, RTA, and Chappie, all have been able to hit their shots. And then, I mean, Little Whip Warriors is a team of pitcher shots.
That's right, and here it is. Last opportunities to make a point have just concluded, and that was the first round. There are four of these, so we're gonna switch up the guards now. Little Whip Warriors get a chance at, you know, trying to earn some points, and as do the others. The next round will begin.
That dragon's so cool. That's definitely so cool. Look at that.
Looks real.
Yo, shout out to the observers. That shot right there, that's really cool. Big fan of it going out. And as you can see now, round two is underway. This is the final match on Junkyard Juke of set two. And right off the bat, two archery targets and a water heater marching on out.
Yep, that archery target is worth 10 points, though. So if you can bring that all the way through, it's one of the, I guess, smaller, large point objects. Magma doesn't even care. He's impatient. He saw the blinds open up. He just kept going. So Venoth did pump the brakes, though. Even right here, notice, stops very early. He's just trying to blend in, get as many points as possible right here.
Ooh. Did get picked up. It might have been the book there. That's the one thing that you need to note that makes it very difficult about the bullseye or the archery target is the fact that because it has those placed legs, you have to be deliberate about where you're setting down. Otherwise, you're right, like, boom, right there. That book would be a giveaway if somebody decided to look down and double check that box. But there's six other boxes around, so relatively safe. Good path chosen there from Tyler and opts to stop and be, you know, a little bit of patient and might have cost him there. I think he would have had it if he had just go full send, and I think he thinks so too.
Yo, it makes me laugh to see him scratch his head, his jaw drops, like, oh, being so close and not making it through is so unfortunate. Tal'Dorf is going to find a little bit of success there as the Suezo, and you saw Alex JJ for a bit is very close to scoring as well. Here's Zan from the Fish Fam representing, hugging really close to that Cactus. So long as he's not pushing through it, yeah, he is going to be able to sneak on out. He kind of hiccups there. He's going to go all the way. He doesn't care if the curtain comes down. He sneaks right underneath Tamoya and his team up top. Funky Fighters are at 35 points now in the guard tower. They can't earn anymore.
And that was a great run there by Zan tonight. You can see Svenos waiting for the blinds to go down, making sure he can find an angle, and then pushing in towards. Needs to be careful of that spring right there, but doesn't matter. Gets picked up anyway as he's like, hey, there wasn't a car there before. Alex JJ now looking to find a run. You can see Fish Fam and Llama Record Co. currently hanging out at the top, but again, haven't had the chance to be up there, so can be expected. Alex JJ now two targets, both running out. Good stops at the same time, but particularly if you have two people taking the same path as the same item, it kind of has a little bit more of a benefit because you're like, yeah, those were both there, but mine. There's no way those are both props.
That's what I was going to say. I was like, you know what? Honestly, if you see a bunch of the same things, they blend in a little more. It's when something's an oddball that you really start to shoot. So maybe it is a good idea for to time it, right?
But the, so there's also, there's split spawns, so you don't always consistently, there's different spawn points around the map that have the different exits as you go out, so you can coordinate with a teammate, or what you can also do is sort of bait somebody else to do it, right? So you see somebody is running an archery target, and you're like, okay, I'm just gonna grab that too, and then you follow their path. And if they get picked up, oh, well, you look slightly more natural, particularly if you're that much more patient. And you can see Svenos is actually doing that right now with Carnifex, both of them going into the box. Svenos does hit the spring, is hanging out behind the car, and will get the score. That was a great run.
Yeah, he actually recognized where he was not looking down in the right direction, so he took advantage of that. Funky Fighter let his guard down for just a second there. He did manage to sneak on through, so that was the big point there in the final seconds as this round is now coming to a close there. Next round is going to begin. We're going to switch up the guards. Take another look.
No dancing, just props and shots going out from the guards. Round three kicking off in the final match of set two. at the Creative Finals. Who will be able to take that second silver llama? And right now, you see Bensor is going in for the 10-point prop right away. Kutu does get the mimic, but then opts to go for a different route as players are starting to feel a little bit of the pressure here. You can tell they need to score points. It's the first time we're starting to see some gnomes out there and another teddy bear on the run.
That's right. Can Taka represent here? He's putting himself straight behind every object that he can. I love that they're using the smaller objects. It's so much easier to score with those. When you bring those big ones out, it really is hard. He actually put himself inside the truck. You see that? He's following Kuta so close here. He's got to use him as bait, really. If you get behind him, he's safe.
Yep, because they don't think they're going to fire twice in there. That's the benefit of it. But right away, you see Kaz, Taco, Chappie. Great little run there from the Little Whip Warriors. That's going to push them back into contention. They're 65 points currently, but a dumpster going in from Hand Above. There's another 10 points for Llama Record, though, pushing them up to 90. And they were the winners of that first match. So if they can hold on, they know they'll be the guards in the final round. They need to build up as much of a lead as possible here.
Carraro actually has 15. Elimination. So he had a super successful guard round, but the Chicken Champions need to get picked up here. They need these points. And there it is. He's doing a lot of work for his team, showing that, hey, I can push this up here too. Just going to go ahead and take that five-pointer, throw him right over the fish fam now. And they're in the top three running.
That was a great run from him. Corner peek the entire time, made sure nobody was looking for him. Like, he was barely threatened. But right now, Bensor coming through. The Chicken Champions, can they overtake in the last minute? That's 10 more points. That is going to go through for them and starts pushing up. Llama Records needs to get in some runs. The Chicken Champions will not be on the defense with them for the last one. So they're pushing it through. Right now, it is the Sunshine Soldiers and the Fish Fam up there. So they're doing their best to delay everyone. X-Sandy gets picked off by Tyler, and now Carnifex is chilling in the back on that rusted out car. Hand of Blood just barely avoids the shot. Saw the hitbox going through there. The Tracers finding a way through the window, but not enough as Dracius gets in. Two more 10-point props also going over, and we're seeing, I think, a little bit closer of a score here, minus the fact that the Chicken Champions haven't shot yet.
Yeah, this is pretty rough. Neither have the Llama Company. The llamas have not shot, went into the guard tower at all. You can tell because when we go to their POVs, they don't have any elims, so they have not taken a run yet.
Yes, excuse me, I misspoke there, meaning the Chicken Champions had already shot.
Llama
needs to press on it. The only team who really has a definitive lead right now is the Chicken Champions. Effectively, they're up 30 points on the rest of the field because Cuddle Team and Llama Record Code both have to shoot next round.
Oh boy, so if they can't secure a big lead here in the last couple of seconds, if something can't get processed, oh, the poor Burger at the very end.
Burger did not get processed. We like it. Never frozen there. Brilliantly done. Doesn't find it. Great work from coming out. And Carnifex doing a great job. Round four will begin. It's going to be the last match, and we're going to see what the line is going to be. Who is up in the tower? Who will be able to defend? And can they hold them off? Again, it's Llama Record Co. and the Cuddle Crew up there.
Go Taga.
It's already up there. And you can see the Chicken Champions were able to connect, so it's all about can Little Whip and them catch up. They need a fantastic run, and they have to do everything to deny them. And you can see right away already tunneling in on those 10-point props.
Yeah, the Cuddle Crew cannot earn points. The Chicken Champions already have the lead. They just kind of continue to press on here. Llama Records are up at their run, but it still matters. There's so much on the line for depending on each game, right? Each game is worth so much. You still want to hold your placement regardless of what. This is still a fantastic game for all the teams in the top three right now.
And I mean, we saw the Ravens come up huge in their last match, pushing all the way from seventh into third because of clutch last-minute decision-making. Right now, Little Whips are trying to do everything they can to catch up with the Chicken Champions and not deny them. Ninja still sticking with the water heater runs, trying to get as many of those in, but the Chicken Champions are still stretching out their lead. They have a 25-point lead, which means the Little Whip Warriors have to either start fast running with the 5-point props or switch to 10-point props. They cannot catch them doing a patient 5-point strategy right now. They won't have enough time with how good the Chicken Champions have been. They have been the prop masters so far.
Yes, they have. They were doing so good. And oh no, Ninja hits a huge spike there. He's trying to dodge, and he's so close to making it through. very, very close. Here comes a 10-pointer from Taldoc. Sneaks it right in. That's great for the Little Whip Warriors. That's actually going to throw them over the Llama Record Company right there. Cuddle Crew actually is somehow up. Look, the Little Whip Warriors actually went to second place now. They're so close to overthrowing the Chicken Champions as well.
It's going to come down to the last final moments. Can the Little Whip Warriors get the runs they need to? You can see Kaz is taking the corner route, trying to find whatever he can, and he's doing it very well so far, avoiding the jump pads. They're pretty sure Ninja called those ones out on the run since he hit them on the last time. You can see they're only 20 points down. They're all on 5-point props right now. They will be able to do it, but all of a sudden, Fish Fam is right there as well. They're only 25 points up. Here comes the rotation on prop. 5 points will be coming across for the Little Whips. Fish Fam also getting it, but Cuddle Crew does finally get pushed up there. Brilliantly done. 15 points now separates them, but Ryan gets one in for the Tender Defenders, pushing it back up to 25 with only 30 seconds remaining. Rubius knows if he can get this water heater in, if he can be safe. Oh, apologies, hidden so well. He was the statue going on there. And as you can see, hits the jump pad, stays on the corner, will get it in. That's going to push them 30 points clear. But as I say that, Fish Fam catches right back up. 19 seconds left, Monster, in the final match of set two on Junkyard Juke. Can the last minute scores come through? 25 points, they need a run of 10s. Kaz got in, the box is coming just behind. Fish Fam gets picked up. The Chicken Champions have done enough to round out the final match. Brilliantly done in match two, repeat in match three. They are the Chicken Champions. Excellently done, and they defended their crown.
That's right, and you have to give props to everyone else that managed to kind of hold a top three lead, especially right there in those final moments. Little Whip Warriors, the Fish Fam really coming up at the end there, you know, bumping up their prize earnings, because every round everyone's a winner, but you can earn just a little bit. You can win a little bit more.
Yeah, it was just brilliantly done there. And these are actually the creators who helped with this. Brilliantly done from them. Some fantastic gentlemen. Thank you guys all so much for your help in making this mode come to life. Some fine gentlemen up there, the creative builders, were at that game jam out there, spent hours and hours, and it really blows my mind to see what they're able to do in this creative mode. Because, like, I'll go in, I'll play some stuff. Yeah, I think I'm pretty good. And they're like, oh, yeah, after 20 minutes, I have this full game mode. Here's how the scoring works. Here's the barriers. I'm like,
and that's the magic of creative, right? These unlimited possibilities, really, when it comes down to coming up with these game modes. We've seen tons of fun ones, obviously developed not only for, you know, the creative kind of fun side of the community, but the comp side as well, right? There's plenty of great game modes out there.
Yeah, shout out to all the guys out there playing Storm Wars. We know you guys enjoy it, but that was a fantastic way to close out set number two. And honestly, I enjoyed Junkyard Juke. It was fun to see kind of the definitive playstyles come out. Patience ended up being key, but players started finding the diagonal runs, knowing that, like, hey, I'm gonna stick with the statue because this is my comfort, or like, I know on this run I can be blocked by this tree and this dumpster and I only show myself once. But again, brilliant from the Fish Fam and Little Whip Warriors to push up and pass those guys in the last moments, pushing them into the top four and earning just a little bit more of that prize money.
That's right, because they want it all here at the Fortnite Creative Finals, and it's going down. So, you know, you love to see it. We've seen a series of, you know, I guess, different people succeeding, right? And all of these, the Chicken Champions really kind of came out.
Well, that's what, again, I love about all of this and about creative. There's so many different skills that Fortnite isn't all about one individual thing. You see these guys and what they're doing is incredibly well. Able to execute the game plan, talk with their teammates, come up with something new, and the Chicken Champions elevated. They were clearly better than the rest at Junkyard Juke, but the question is, will that continue when we get into the Golden Games? Right now, we're gonna get a chance to speak with the Chicken Champions, who's up top with Pooks. Pooks, what do you got for us?
Thank you so much, Sundown. I am down here with the Chicken Champions, who surprisingly didn't fly the coop. They put on an absolute clinic today in the Creative Trials. I'm here with Rubius. Now, you guys won the last game as well, so two in a row. You guys had a pretty great strategy. Do you want to kind of talk me through that a little bit?
Oh, what can I say? It's the power of Norway, the power of Spain, and the power of Detroit. Like, we're crushing it. And we're a chicken, so we're good at hiding. Like, we're not good at shooting and stuff, but at hiding, we're the best. The best strategy, I think, is, well, let him take the big stuff, and we are like the supports. Like, we take the small stuff, the 5 points and stuff, and stuff like that, and the trick is, don't tell him anybody, but the trick is to go in the corners. Like, go in, no one is watching the corners. It's insane.
So no one is watching the corners. I hope all of your competitors did not hear you just say that. Now, he said that you were in charge of taking the big items. Does that put a little bit more pressure on you?
No, it's good. It works good, so.
So you guys have a ton of confidence now. You have won 2 games in a row. I'm so excited to see how you all perform in the rest of the day. Going into these next games, do you have anything you're going to change, or are you going to keep things the same?
We're just going to keep things the same, stay consistent, keep a little ahead, play slow. That's really it. So.
And finally, just for you there on the end, I just want to talk a little bit about, you touched on the diversity of this group. Yeah. Now, I know you guys have really not played together much before. What has that been like, coming together, playing here with your teammates from all over the world?
It's amazing to share these moments with my team, and the next mode, it's amazing. And bueno, this parkour, I think my team is very good in parkour. We win.
You guys are so confident. I love it. Hopefully that carries on into your next games. Congratulations again, guys. Thank you so much. Sundown, back to you.
Can I send some love to Twitch chat?
Oh, let's go. Twitch chat. Twitch chat. There we go.
YouTube. Hey, it's everywhere, man. Thanks for the plug out there, El Rubius. Fantastically well done. Love to everyone all over, no matter where you're watching, whether it's Fortnite.com/watch, on Twitch, on YouTube, in client, you're loading up all that stuff. Thank you guys so much for all of this and being here. Set 2 is done. It's wrapped up. But I mean, we saw a big shift in the gameplay. We saw a lot of different changes going on, and it's going to be interesting to see what ends up converting into the Golden Games when we see a little bit of a remix on it. Not going to spoil any surprises. I know it's fine, but I'm just curious to see who is able to then take their gameplay and enact it when you get to think on it, because you get to then process and be like, okay, we were this close. We were right there. If we had maybe like a little bit more aggressive, or like maybe if we were a little bit better on defending, or maybe one person picked a different lane, the result could have been different. And these guys have been so good at adapting to the circumstances that I have no doubt that the Chicken Champions aren't just going to comfortably sit on top.
Yeah, not only that, they gave away some strategy, so we'll see if Bala outside can, you know, kind of break that down and see if he can give us a little more insight on everything.
Thank you so much, guys. The action is heating up. It's also heating up outside, trying to cool off a little bit here at the Fan Festival, but awesome games of Junkyard Juke, and Chicken Champion seems to be racing away with this one. We're going to take a look at some of the moments from that last game and how they won. So here, first off, just having a good time in the front, and also maybe also flexing a little bit their trophy that they may have just secured in terms of a llama. We'll find out that later. But their strategy the entire time, they said it before in the last game, they're just trying to go for the high points. They're just trying to score these, at least getting not those 2 points that Monster was advocating for, but go for the statues, go for the boilers, all those things that net you tons of points, and that's how they came out to a lead. Here it is again, them just cheering on. We have the reactions from the Chicken Champions on their win as well. Nice trophy lifts. Maybe they'll be doing that later on here. The statue using that to get above the opponent's vision, their field of view, so that they can't see, they can't hit their shots, and the reactions of the win. Just bliss as they win their second game there on Junkyard Juke. Absolutely amazing stuff, guys. I can't wait to see who's going to earn that and who's going to continue on towards their path to the Creative World Cup champions.
Thank you so much, Bala, for that in-depth analysis. Now, I know you guys want to see the standings. We want to see them as well. Unfortunately, there was a slight little hiccup. We want to make sure everything is right, because this is a huge moment for all of these guys up on that stage. So while we sort that